इतना सफर है कुछ होने में और बहुत कुछ होने में, इतना सा फर्क है एक बार सोच के छोड़ देने में और लग के कर दिखाने में, मान लेने में कि जिंदगी ऐसे ही कटेगी और सुबह 4 बजे उठ के सोचने में कि अभी तो बस शुरुआत है, किसी मैगजीन को हाथ में लेने में और उसी मैगजीन के कवर पेज पे होने में इतना सा ही तो फर्क है, VIP सीट में और उसकी पिछली सीट में इतना सा ही तो फर्क है, वो जिसका मैदान ही खुला आसमान है वही कल जमीन पर तो था, पूछोगे तो बताएगा वो पंछी, ये एक दायरे में सिमटने में और पूरी दुनिया को दायरा बनाने में बस इतना सा फर्क है, इतना कितना है, इतना है या इतना है, जो नापेगा वो जाने कि जहां धरती और आसमान मिलते हैं, नानकुर से दूर अगर मगर शायद से दूर, वहां भी दोनों में फर्क बस इतना सा है, धरती और सातवें आसमान में फर्क बस इतना सा है, ये एक अंतर प्रेरणा है, ये हमारी आपकी हम सब की अंतर प्रेरणा है, एक कदम एक छलांग एक बाजी एक गहरी सांस और एक ललकार खुली हवाओं में कि हां मैं बना हूं उन फिजाओं के लिए, कि हां मैं बना हूं उन ऊंचाइयों के लिए जो ऊंची तो बहुत है पर नामुमकिन भी नहीं, क्योंकि मुमकिन और नामुमकिन में बस इतना सा फर्क, धूप छांव में फर्क बस इतना सा, तो बस चलिए फ्रेंचाइज इंडिया के साथ ये फर्क मिटा देते हैं, फ्रेंचाइज इंडिया 20 years of ideas.
Good afternoon, one and all. Thank you so much, Dheeraj, for playing the corporate brand video of Franchise India. Franchise India is Asia's largest integrated franchise solution company. It was established in 1999, and we enjoy absolute authority on franchising, licensing, and retailing. We have helped thousands of investors in selecting their right business opportunity while assisting and supporting numerous organizations internationally and nationally to expand their business. The first company to introduce and develop franchise market in India is Franchise India, covering different markets. We welcome you to this Business Opportunity of Chai webinar series. This is our 137th episode. This is a digital platform where our aim is to present to you the brand of the day. We do not endorse any particular brand. We welcome our panel members today, the management team of Franchise India, Mr. Gaurav Maurya and Ms. Sonia Chaudhary. And today, during the course of the webinar, they'll be sharing their suggestions, their thought process, their advice with each one of us while interacting and talking about the brand. Today, we are representing the brand Panisa Capital Exchange, world's largest 24/7 cryptocurrency trading platform. The brand, which was established in 2018, incorporated in 2018, is a trading platform from Singapore. Their various facts and figures talk about their reach. They are already present in 8+ countries with 250+ global franchisees and 100+ freelancers. And it's our privilege to welcome the team of Panisa Exchange Capital with us. We welcome Ms. Ahuja. She's the director at the brand. Mr. Sandeep Fogart, who is the founder and CEO, along with Ms. Shukla, she's the compliance manager. Thank you so much, everyone, for joining us today. Over to you, Ms. Shukla, to take us through the journey of your brand.
You're on a mute.
Ms. Shukla, we request you to please unmute yourself.
Am I audible now?
Yes, yeah, thank you so much.
All right. Hello, everyone. Hope you're having a good day. I am Payaswini Shukla, your presenter for the day. Let me take you through the journey of something great I have been a part of, that is Panisa Capital. Panisa Capital is a Singapore-based company which started its journey in the year 2017. It moved forward with expanding itself in various countries like Hong Kong, Thailand, Singapore, Dubai, and Estonia, and checked their various markets. After a while, it was now time to head back home. It was only in the year 2018, Panacea Capital, a fintech company, found its roots in India. Now, the word fintech means financial technology, which aims to compete with the traditional financial methods in the delivery of financial services. Okay, so what does an investor seek? An investor seeks for security, accessibility, and transparency in his investments. So, to add to the existing Indian market and revolutionize the investments in how people think or plan in India, Panacea Capital brought a cryptocurrency exchange platform. Panacea Capital launched PCEX, a cryptocurrency exchange, in the year 2019 from Estonia. Now, Estonia is one among the very few countries in the world which has got very crisp regulations and clear laws when it comes to cryptocurrencies. In other words, it is NSE for your cryptos. It is an exchange that follows B2B model, keeping in mind the requirements of the Indian market. In the beginning though, we started as a B2C exchange, but seeing the attention and interest people had in the cryptocurrency, we introduced the B2B model as well. Along with the marginal decline in the stock market and to the traditional market of NSE, people really got their interest sort of risen in the crypto market. Now, in the same year after the introduction of the B2B model, we were able to make around 250 plus franchisees and freelancers under PCEX. Unfortunately, due to the unclear laws and regulations in India, we were just not there. But as people say, hard work does not go in vain, and universe works its magical ways to get us what you desire. With the change in the stand of the government of India with respect to the crypto market and legality of using Indian rupees, we got an impetus to put our best foot forward. Keeping the same in mind, PCEX, an Estonia-based exchange, joined hands with Panacea Capital Private Limited and Panacea Capital Traders Private Limited in June to provide an easy access and make the investment hassle-free. For the investor, wherein the PCPL serves as an exchange partner of PCEX, and PCX member under PCTPL became the first broker of PCX India. In the following month, we were able to get DG Broking as another broker under PCEX. We are now moving forward with our head held high, and soon enough, we will be able to onboard two more brokers under PCEX in the coming month, as their trading platform is sort of over and it is in the testing phase. Now, with the successful association with Franchisee India, we hope to achieve greater heights and join more hands in the coming times, as it is one of the best players in the market. Now, as we say, great minds discuss ideas. The great brains behind the whole idea are Mr. Sandeep Fogart, CEO, founder, director, Mrs. Bhavna Fogart, the co-founder and the director, and Ms. Chavi Ahuja, co-founder and director. Now, as previously discussed, we already discussed about the global reach of our company. I present you the client base which is globally present with us. This is our roadmap moving forward. This is the business model that we present. You can easily see the PCEX exchange. It is the exchange platform, and underneath comes the trading member and the authorized member. Now, when you consider the NSE, the traditional market that Indians are comfortable with, trading member can be easily compared with the broker, and the authorized member could be easily compared with the sub-brokers and the franchisees. As you can see, the spot trading, options trading, and the futures trading underneath. So these are the types of trading that we are offering. Currently, we are active with the spot trading, and in the coming times, we will be presenting you with the futures trading too. And of course, options trading later. We've got a very active clearing and settlement department for the brokers too. Moving forward, these are the benefits that we offer. You can easily see the higher revenue that we are hoping for. If I give you an example and talk about the NSE, if you are placing a trade of 10 lakh rupees, you are getting a transaction cost or maybe the commission of 20 rupees and even up to 1 crore rupees, you are getting 20 rupees. But when it comes to the crypto market and you trade for 1 crore rupees, you are earning up to 20 to 30,000 rupees. So there is really no comparison between the revenues. We present high security standards as it employs a five-layer security model, which just leaves 1 in a billion chance of your account being compromised. We offer higher liquidity. We offer continuous technical support. You can work independently as you are the master of your exchange. And it offers promising business opportunities. You can trade and invest in cryptocurrencies, which are more than 10 plus on our cryptocurrency exchange. As it is not stock market, it is a cryptocurrency market. It is 24/7 operational. We offer really low transaction fees, which is around 10x lower than any other exchange has to offer. We've got multiple channel system. We've got very simple cross-border payment support and a 5-layer security model as already discussed. These are our trading options. As already discussed about the spot trading, we are charging a transaction cost of around 0.1% only. And in the futures, we'll be having 0.05%. Coming times, we'll be deciding for the options too. This is our India business plan. As you can see and already discussed, under PCEX comes the PCEX member. We've got master franchisee, franchisee and freelancers under PCEX member. And also the client comes the lowest in the hierarchy. So this particular chart represents the zonal data from major cities around India and presents the opportunity or the projection that you can have in the terms of sub-brokers and the brokers. The broker model that we've got in our PCEX offers the below. So the cloud-based trading platform is offered in broker model. We offer a wallet integration, multi-layer security as already discussed. It is a very safe and secure model as it employs 5-layer security. We provide app development and maintenance, continuous server setup and marketing and PR support. As you can see the broker model, as a broker of PCX, you become your own master and you hold the right to do the transactions as it deems fit to you. And you can further decide your commission structure and whatnot. You can easily see the eligibility criteria that we have to offer for the broker. Moving forward, this is the franchisee. So as a PCX member franchisee, you can add multiple number of clients and you can enjoy up to 40% of commission on our platform. This also lists the eligibility criteria for the franchisees. As you can see on your screen, this is the ideal broker partner profile primarily. So for the broker or the master franchisee, existing brokers with other stock trading companies like India Bulls or Sher Khan and last sub brokers keen to graduate to broker level can opt for broker or the master franchisees. Now, the new investors who have the capacity could always go for the sub broker model. Talking about why cryptocurrency trading, see, the primary difference or the primary reason we are going for crypto market is because stock market is at its saturation point. It has been there for a long time now and the growth process is quite slow. It amounts to around 10 to 12% of growth in the coming years. Whereas when you talk about the crypto market, it is a new and booming industry of around 300 billion, 50 billion. So you can always see the opportunity that you're getting there. Now stocks have a very fixed trading time, which is around 9:30 to 4 p.m. And this crypto market is a 24/7 market. The substantial amount of profit is a slow process in case of stock market. And when it comes to the crypto market, it is a very instant profit and loss period. This is the SWOT analysis. The strength, as I always said, is a distributed ledger technology, which is very transparent. It protects you from the fraud and the cross-border remittances are very easy. Threats, of course, since it is internet, it is prone to cyber fraud. So this particular graph represents the cryptocurrencies around the world, except in terms of acceptance. Turkey, Brazil, a lot of countries have been included in this particular survey. So these are the marketing initiatives that we can do for you. Since we have a global presence in around 6+ countries, we can always help you capture the coin market around the world. We provide marketing and branding solutions. You don't really have to look forward for a third party to provide you IT and marketing support. And of course, the 24/7 technical support. Okay, so moving forward, I'd ask our colleague to continue, please.
who's now presenting, Paswini?
So, Mr. Anshul is going to take over the financial model, the financial structure.
Okay. Anshul, over to you. Just run the financial structure.
Yes, sir. Good afternoon, sir. Person, if you can keep the presentation on, please.
Sure, just a minute. Okay.
So, in the financial sense, you know, so there are two business models, as Payaswini has mentioned already. We're looking at a broker level, and then there is a sub broker, right? for the broker, which essentially becomes, a larger entity who would also then bring in sub brokers under them, right? So, in this case, the broker we're looking at a slightly larger office, about 1,000 to 1,200 square feet. Which would have a seating space as well. Key points to note here is the terminal software, which is 14 lakh rupees. That would be a critical investment in this business. Apart from that, interior fit out, equipment costing, and other things. So overall, an investment of about 30 lakh rupees. Please note, there is no franchise fee in this case. So this is a zero franchise fee model. Of course, there are revenue share structure royalties later on, but initial upfront, there is no franchise fee, right? Similarly, if I go to the sub-broker model, so sub-broker can be a very small setup, just a 200 square feet space. And here, the terminal software cost is very minimal, just a 15,000 rupee license. That you need to take. So overall, the investment here is just 4 lakh rupees to start the work. You know, essentially, the sub broker can also start, from a small office, home office sort of a setup, and need not invest in infrastructure also. You know, so in that case, the investment can further be brought down by another lakh rupee or so. Right. So, and again, please note, there's no franchise fee again in this case as well. So two opportunities here. One is a broker, which essentially is a larger entity who's looking at developing a sub-broker network under him, plus also doing this trading platform himself, right? So investment for that model is about 30 lakh rupees, which includes 14 lakh rupees on the terminal software, plus your interior fit-outs, trade licenses and a few other things. The second opportunity is a sub-broker, which is an independent entity, can be started from a small office, home office setup to begin with. And later on, you can, take up an independent office as well. The software here is just 15,000 rupee, just the license to log in onto the platform, right? So overall, the investment between 3 to 4 lakh rupees to begin with for a sub-broker, right? So then, Payaswini, the presentation is not there. Okay, it's there, sure. So in terms of the revenue share now for the sub-broker, as Payaswini mentioned that we have two opportunities here. One is spot. And the second is futures trading, right? So for the spot trading, yes, the presentation is back here. If you can quickly go to the financial slide, because it would people would not be able to understand the numbers.
Yeah, just a second.
Yes, please. Yeah.
We've moved to the financial slide. I think it opens up the first slide. You need to scroll it down.
Yeah, is it possible now?
This is the opening slide. We need to go to financial slides. When you do a slideshow, it starts from the first slide.
Yeah, please scroll to the financial slide, no? Yes, Vinny. So overall, you know, from the investor side, on the spot business, which is, you know, the sub-broker makes 0.1% as 0.1% of the total transaction value.
Anshul, let me interrupt. I think let's get on the slide because it's a very important financials. So I think let's the financial slide be open, then people can understand better.
Sure, sir.
Yeah, that's right. Now you can go on that. Okay.
Sure. If you can go to the next slide, I think this is for the broker. We need to first look at the sub-broker slide, please.
This is actually what we are offering. If you could continue on this for the broker.
No, we need to first discuss the sub-broker numbers, actually. Then we can come to this slide. It should be the next slide, in fact.
Is it the same one?
Yes, yes, this one, please. Yes, correct. Okay, so as we are saying, you know, so the broker, the sub-broker, in fact, would have the role to, of course, reach out to the clients in his assigned territory. And from each client, you know, the transaction value for the spot businesses, and this is what we have experienced in the current setup. 75,000 INR is the first, is the daily transaction per client. And given the number of clients that you would have active with you, the INR value over the month can be generated. So as you can see, these numbers is 45 lakhs and 1.35 crore, 2.25 crores. So, you know, depending on the number of active clients that you would have, what we have seen as an average transaction value per client per day, it comes to about 75,000 rupees, right? And on that transaction value, in the spot category, you make 0.12% as your brokerage, correct? Similarly, if we go to the future value, now in future, of course, the number of clients would be very small, and the average transaction value per day per client, what we have seen is close to 20 lakh rupees. And you know, and in this case, the brokerage that you make is 0.3%. Piasnik, if you could go back to the last slide only. Yes, please stay on this slide. Yes. So in future, as I said, the number of clients, active clients, would be smaller, but the transaction value per client per day is close to 20 lakh rupees, right? So though the number of clients are small, the transaction value becomes huge, right? And on this category, you make, as a sub-broker, you make 0.03%. It is 0.03% of the transaction value becomes your brokerage, right? So as a sub-broker, you have two revenue lines. One is 0.1% on the spot business and 0.03% on the future business, right? So overall, what we see, you know, that you have a potential to generate about 20 lakh rupees annually as your gross brokerage value. Of course, you would have your expenses from that to be taken care of, which could be your rents, if you put a person with you, your electric bill and a few other things, right? So overall, 1.5 to 2 lakh rupees every month is your gross earning as a sub broker, and you can, you know, easily net about a lakh every month as a net earning from this business, right? Similarly, if we go to the broker piece now, the broker slide. So brokers, of course, as I said, they have a responsibility to develop a sub broker network under them. So depending on number of sub brokers that you do, all the numbers would add up, and also they would have their own sub-broker operations with them. So alongside this 20 lakh rupees annual brokerage, they would also be receiving a brokerage share from the sub-broker network under them. Next slide, please. On this broker slide.
Hello, everyone. Anshul, I'd like to add a few points in it.
Yes, please.
So talking about these are the just estimates. And if we talk about a trading part in our NSE or MCX or something, the numbers are very huge. So we have come up with the very less numbers. If we get a very limited clients and we have limited people, then also we can make a huge amount of money. Today in NSE or MCX, there's a huge competition which has reduced the ROI. And due to the competition, we have come up to a brokerage on transaction basis. But still, market, there's a brokerage available on volume basis. And this market is expanding day by day. Moreover, there's no other company which is providing physical offices or providing franchisee so that people can have a relevance background or people can have a support. Every company today you see, they are just online and they are just moving on. And being an Indian, I do understand that. Until unless we have some physical office or some RM representative, we don't believe anyone. So these numbers can be multiplied massively. They can be multiplied massively. And talking about revenue part, whether it's broker or whether it's franchisee, we have kept our fees structure in such a form that any investment made by anyone can be recovered within 6 months. I hope it was something that can be added on. Anshul, you can continue now.
Yes. Yes. So, you know, given these two opportunities, this is very exciting opportunity, as Sandeep sir also mentioned, that, you know, monies can be recovered very quickly in this case. The transaction value become, you know, multiplies very quickly once you get to about, you know, a sizable base of investors with you, right? And somebody who's already a stock broker, you know, with somebody like India Bulls or a Sharekhan or IIFL or Zerodha and many other companies, right? If you're already an existing stock broker, this could be a very exciting additional service to your setup, you know, both for a broker level or for a sub broker level as well. You know, because you would already have the infrastructure with you. And this becomes an additional service that you can offer to your existing investor base also, right? So in that sense, very exciting opportunity. A significant amount of money can be made in this business. Yeah. Yes, sir. Sandeep, please. Personally, if you can go to the next slide, please. I can close the presentation then.
Yes, that's the end.
Yes. On the summary slide, in the last one. The business. Yes, stay on this piece, yes. So, you know, as has been discussed in this presentation before, this is a future-led opportunity. We've all seen what cryptocurrency, bitcoins, you know, have done over the past 5-7 years since it started happening globally. High liquidity, high revenue sharing. There's absolutely a business growth opportunity. As I said, existing stockbrokers, this becomes a very interesting addition to your service. Optimal security, robust processes. So company has invested a significant amount of money in terms of creating the right infrastructure, creating the right processes, you know, ensuring the investors' money is safeguarded. There is no scope for any cyber crimes, anything like that to happen. You know, and the great advantage for this business is if you are a stock, for an investor, if you're investing in stocks in India, it is only Monday to Friday and idly 9 to 3:30 sort of timeline, only about 6-7 hours in the day. Right, but this is available 24/7, you know, across the globe. One of the market is always open, so you can always be, you know, in the trading mode. And then, of course, company is offering a significant amount of lead mapping support and marketing and branding support to attract more and more investors with you. Right. So overall, I would suggest, and this is a very interesting, very exciting opportunity. It's a future opportunity now. We may have missed out investing in Bitcoins earlier, but this could be the right time now to venture into Bitcoin cryptocurrency trading. Existing stockbrokers, again, I would say this is a very interesting add-on to your existing investor base, your existing infrastructure, and you know, this could be very interesting for you guys. With that, sir, Gaurav, sir, I would like to invite you to take us to the next steps, please.
Thank you. The team at PCX, I think it's a great opportunity. And what we will do is now we'll get into a Q&A section and try to understand a little more in detail. Thanks, Sandeep. Thanks, Chavi. And thanks for the presentation and being part of it. So we would like to get started on explaining the business model. And Sandeep, this is a request from you know, my side, in terms of if you can really take people, because a lot of people have heard cryptocurrency but they don't really understand in depth. So two things I would like from you. One, obviously give us a little overview about the overall industry, how it is shaping, what is happening in India, what is the size of business already in India, and where do you see this is moving in next 2 to 3 years. That's one. And second, also, let's talk about the company and how you founded the company and what is the background and what is the founder group, you know, and what is their, because people, when they invest into opportunities, they would like to know who are they dealing with, who are these, the company and the founder group. So over to you with these two questions starting from.
Thank you, Gaurav-ji. Hello, everyone. It's a great opportunity to come on board with Franchise India, number one company for franchising in India. So coming to the point, trading of cryptos is nothing different than the trading in stocks or MCX or commodities. It's near about the same. The technology has changed out. Like in previous years, we used to use a car which was old fashioned, and then came out the Mercedes. So in the same format, now we have new technologies in which blockchain is involved, and blockchain helps getting us a better one area for trading part. It trading profile is the same. Like in shares, we have demat account. Over here, we have wallet services. Wallet was a different world 10 years back. Today people are aware about wallets. What is wallet? Whether people are aware about Paytm wallets, MobiKwik wallets, in the same format. When shares were in a physical form, now they are electronic formed and they are known as demat accounts. So demat accounts have been replaced by wallets, and the trading pattern is same. We have two options. One, a customer is directly going to the exchange without any mediator. And another one, which all of the stock exchanges prefer, that there's an exchange which is governed by a government or regulated by a government, and it has various franchisees, brokers, to facilitate their customers.
Correct.
Now we talk about first model, where direct exchange comes and interacts with the client. In that model, it is a cheaper one for the exchange, but it is difficult for a customer because there's only one office, there's only customer service available. Either you need to call them or you need to just email them. Now customer who has invested a lot of money, he can't wait for those calls or emails. If suppose I'm not getting a proper reply on email, whom should I approach? This is a major problem in that case. And when we go in hierarchy business, like this NSE, now NSE has various brokers like India Bulls, Religare, SMC, Angel, and they have their branch offices in smaller areas even. If we go in a remote area, then also you can find a franchise. A client can visit his office. He can go there, he can put his complaint, he can have assistance, and majority of people who are not technically sound faces out the problem. And this hierarchy model solves that problem, that they have a proper RM who can assist them. So these are two ways. So we preferred second one, that we should go through hierarchy base. We were the first one to launch this, although it is a process which takes some time, because to open various outlets, it is going to take time. And instead of opening outlet, if I go by marketing and I reach out thousands of customers or crores of customers, it's easy. So we prefer second one so that we can give a proper customer satisfaction. So that's why we came into this business. And talking about stocks market, we have been in stocks and we left stocks in 2008. After that, you can see stock market profits are daily declining. Today, due to competition, only you get 20 rupees per transaction. Anybody from a stock market in a since 30 years, 40 years experience, you can just talk to him and he'll say that there's no profit now left. It is hard to make out your expenses even. But there's opportunity in crypto market, although it has not come up with a huge number still today, but numbers are increasing day by day. People are adapting it. It will take some time. Like Paytm took some time. The day Paytm came up, nobody believed it. That what is wallet? We don't believe it. Money, they'll take off money and they'll run off. Same happened with Bitcoin cryptocurrencies. Cryptocurrencies came up, education was not there, people were not aware. Scams also happened. But day by day, regulations are coming up. Various countries have come up with the regulations. Now, India has also removed out the bans and also. It is evolving up.
So, very, very good information. I think the two things which they are trying to do under the exchange is that they're bringing wider distribution. What he's saying is that creating a broken network creates much wider distribution. The problem was that a lot of people wanted to participate. And even today also, India has one of the lowest penetration when it comes to even stock market. We have a very little people having demat accounts and so on and so forth. So imagine the distribution, how much it can really pay. While it is a reach to saturation from a price point viewpoint, only 20 rupees from per transaction. So while the stock market sometimes we hear is making a lot of money, but the broking is not making money. So you please try to differentiate. There is a difference between broking and the stock market. Stock market doing well has nothing to do with broking. Broking is the margins you make on the trading, right? So what we're trying to do, even at this stage, crypto volume is low towards the main exchange, but the per trading margin is much higher, you know? So fundamentally, for the brokers, you are much better off rather than working on a conventional old stock market. You can go to a newer trading exchanges and so on. So that's one part. Now let's go to a business model. Business model is two ways. There is a broker, which is conventionally similar when you had stock market also, and then you have sub brokers, which are franchisees running in. Before I go to understanding of dividing how the geographically they would be divided, let's talk about a legal structure. What is the legal structure currently saying? Because a lot of people still perceive, and this has happened almost every new exchange coming in. I know, remember when commodity exchange came in, everybody was talking the same way. This would work, not burst. It will happen. This would happen. Scam would happen. And we had scams also in that, but we still feel that this is just not a fair play by somebody. Doesn't mean that the exchange or structure would not work. So where we are in crypto, I think the crypto has seen a lot of noise, especially in India also. But where are we in the legal structure? What does the regulator tells us on the crypto side?
Talking about the legalities, in various developed countries, we already have regulations right now. Like we have license from Estonia and Estonia has regulated it. India hasn't come up with any regulation, but in March, Supreme Court came up with a statement that it is not illegal. Regulatories are going to come up very soon. So the time, like today in NSE, we have SEBI as a regulator. In cryptos, we don't have a regulator today, but very soon we are going to see that. Regulation comes in a play when there's a market out there, when people are using it. Like the day NSE was launched or BSE was launched, there was no regulator over there. But slowly, gradually, as the market share grew up, the government came up with a body. In the same format, as we are growing up, a body is going to come up. And we at our own, we are trying to follow the laws made by SEBI for stock exchanges. We are trying to follow that so that we don't go out of the boundaries. We are trying to keep those things inside.
Very important point you've raised, and I think a lot of people, regulation, they don't follow that. Regulation is not really about how legal the trade is. So the trade is legal in India, but the regulator is not there. And I can give you one example. The biggest commodity we all traded on was real estate. You know, so the real estate had hundreds and hundreds of years of history and broking going on. Only 5 years back, we have got RERA, right? Yeah. So it's the biggest trading class in the country still is real estate. Only 5 years back, we got the regulator dedicated for real estate. So as the volume would increase and more and more participation happens, for a consumer interest, the regulation really comes in. So that there is a fair play, transparency, industry guidelines, monopolistic environment, a lot of these things not to be controlled, the regulator really comes in. So I feel that as the volume and overall participation per capita increases for people to participate in the cryptocurrency, I think the regulator would follow. And that's where I think the opportunity. So now let's get into the financial model. I think there are two models which we clearly talked about. One is a sub-broker and a broker model. A sub-broker had a certain amount of trading guidelines. But being realistic, if I start a sub-broking structure, what is the time frame and what kind of volume I can do? While Anshul has shown that there is a overall acquisition side, he's shown something, and then he's taken assumption of 75,000 rupees per person per day trading kind of thing, and he's only taken two people actively trading and taking for 30 odd days, it becomes 45 lakh rupees, and then depending on that, there is some kind of percentage which is there. But on a realistic terms, what kind of trading volumes as a sub-broker one you can do, and also explain people what is the difference between spot and future. A lot of people who know stock market, they understand, but a lot of people who don't understand, it will be good for them to explain them.
So I'll take with spot and future first. Spot means on the spot, you are getting a delivery of that same product. Like in NSE or somewhere else, it takes 3 days, trading plus 2 days. Now over here, suppose I buy a Bitcoin. On the same time, same spot, I got a delivery in my wallet. Now I can transfer it to any other exchange, any other wallet. Nobody can stop me. So it is not going to take time. It is not going to take 2 days, 3 days. On the spot, the time you buy, you have that thing. And now futures is a contract where a customer comes up and he says, there's a prediction from my side that it is going to go up. So it's just sort of a contract that he's saying, I want to buy a contract for 1 month, just based on the prices. Today it is 10,000 and I feel it is going to go for 12,000 and I don't want to pay money, entire money. I'll just pay you 5% as my margin money and I'll wait for its profit and loss. The day it comes in profit, suppose it's 11,000, he can sell it anytime he gets his 5% along with the profit. So he only plays on profit and loss.
Yeah.
Spot person takes a physical delivery.
It's a future trading. You actually bet on the future trading on that and take some action on that. It has a lot is done on the stock market on this now, and especially mature brokers would do a lot of work on that. But it's not for somebody who's a new in the trade.
It's for those people who want a higher return on lesser amount. So I'm talking about franchisee and broker. If I compare it with MCX sub-broker or NSC sub-broker, any good NSC sub-broker has a volume of 20 to 50 crores per day. A sub-broker I'm talking about.
Yeah, yeah.
It has a handsome amount of clients. He has 20 to 50 crore rupees volume per day.
Correct. So that is very, very average.
10% of it.
Yeah.
He gets only 10% of it. That means he's attaining near about 5 crore per day volume. And let it be futures volume instead of equity, because it's spot market, then he's earning a huge amount. But if it is futures volume, then also he's making out near about 5,000 a day. 5,000 a day means 1 lakh rupee, 50,000 a month. And in case it is in spot market, then thrice of it, he makes 4.5 lakh rupees. But this would be possible only for existing sub-broker because he has a client base. If suppose a new one enters up, he will have to create a clients, and to attain a volume of 5 crores or 1 crore, you will require at least 10 active clients. 10 active clients can make you have a volume of 1 crore rupees with the average amount of 1 to 2 lakh rupees.
Sure. Sure, that's very helpful. And now the next question I would have before I pass it on to Sonia is that, you know, every market, how do you divide the markets and how do you want to give the so to say, a broker license? Is it city-based or a state-based? Or how do you want to distribute that? And what kind of exclusivity you're giving per region and how the region are divided? That's one. And second, if for reason that my region doesn't have a broker currently, and I want to start as a sub-broker, is there a possibility to do that?
Yeah. The best part of this market is there is no region boundaries. It is a global platform. Suppose you are having a franchisee office in Delhi, you can have clients from US even. It is a global platform. It works 24/7 along with without boundaries of countries or something. It's a global platform. So no region specific.
Very, very important point is done. So it means that you can really create your broking practice even bigger, which means that somebody really starts as a broker, which is a master, and can really appoint sub brokers all over country and even outside. So you really can build your practice at a very, very big level. And that's how actually, if you really see stock market also, you have about 100 odd top brokers in India, which probably would contribute 30-40% of the total stock market value. Top 100, because these people have actually larger broking networks. You know, these can be the Motilals and the Angel Brokings and likes of them, because they have created a large distribution under them. So these broking houses are become much, much bigger. So this is a great timing for people to really go and take a broker license and quickly go and create their large network. If you create your large network, then it will stay with you for years to come. And that's how you will be able to do that. This is absolutely the same time when India Bulls or a Sher Khan or likes of them really entered the market, when stock market broking started getting organized. And we had fortune to work at Franchise India with all of these in early 2000 and places like that, where these companies really started mushrooming through franchising or cross board. And similar kind of opportunity I see for the crypto. So over to you, Sonia, for your questions and a lot of questions, which if you want to take it from audience.
Thank you so much. I think we've tried and covered a lot, but maybe to start off with, I'll say, you know, as far as Asia Pacific region is concerned, cryptocurrency is way ahead than the global, I would say the world at large. And Singapore obviously is the global leader as far as the cryptocurrency is concerned. Well, India, we had, I think in 2018, like you rightly mentioned, we had some issues with the regulations, and recently, the Supreme Court lifted the ban that was there. But we still, you know, there are still risks which are involved in this business. And first of all, which I want to even understand for all the users, is there a code of conduct, you know, from maybe the internet or the mobile association? Is that in place yet, one? And second, what are the KYCs which is needed for people to become users on this platform?
For KYC part, you require proper ID proofs. There's a selfie, latest photograph, and your bank proof, so that we can identify a person, whether he's genuine or not. So a proper KYC part has to be taken care. And talking about the internet laws, they are present. Although regulatory is not there, but we have laws and guidelines from the government regarding internet and transaction services. We already have that. And we are trying to follow each and everything, whether it's from Estonia, whether it's from Singapore. We are trying to follow whatever practices we can, because although we are licensed from Estonia, but we are trying to follow Indian laws as well, Singapore laws as well, because we have our global presence.
And also, you know, Pandeep, I want to understand, you know, while I don't know if this number is right, but they, during what I was reading recently, they're close to 1.7 million registered users of cryptocurrencies in India. So, and you know, how big this market you think would become in this year, you know, and because currently the bill of cryptocurrency is still pending with the government. And so what are the potential risk of somebody using, you know, being a subscriber on the platform, user on the platform, or a transaction? Can there be a potential risk of users and transactions happening on the platform for reason this bill is not passed?
Okay, I'll answer this. First, 1.7 users you are mentioning, I'm telling you, this is guaranteed, it is much more higher than that. Because all of the users doesn't come up in a notice. Other part, talking about problems or legality issues, in recent past, if you see, the time India came up with the ban, India never came up with the ban of cryptocurrencies. India came up with the ban that you can't convert into INR. that you can't convert them into fiat currency. If India, let it be a worst case, if India comes up with again a law that you can't convert it to fiat currency, then also there's no problem. Because in previous past also, India came out that nobody is going to facilitate conversion of INR. But your assets are your assets. You can trade them. You can convert them to other digital assets. And out of India, if you spoke, you can just have a view. Companies like Amazon, Microtech, these are also accepting your payments in cryptos. So crypto is today widely accepted all across. If India says that you can't convert them into INR, but still it will come up with a time frame of 90 days, 180 days or 6 months, that within 6 months, please convert them. Like all of a sudden, we all woke up and we knew that notes are banned now. There's demonetization done. But government came up with a timeline that within this much timeline, you can convert your money. So they are going to come up. And we are there. We guarantee for this that we'll support you and we'll make it happen that whatever your digital assets are there with you. Because we'll convert them, we'll help you. Our presence is global. If India comes up with the law that they are not aligned up, we'll help you out. We have international banks and all. We are there.
Sure. So the question which I want to pick up is, you know, like you mentioned, it is currently being used on platforms like Amazon. So what are the various uses of this cryptocurrency? Where all can this be used? In what kind of transactions? If you can even help PBR viewers understand the various uses of cryptocurrency.
They are using just like a fiat money that you can pay through Bitcoin. So it can be used as an investment tool. It can be used as a payment tool. In India, it is not allowed to use as a payment tool. But outside India, it is allowed to be used as a payment tool. You can find various ATMs available for cryptocurrencies out of India, but not in India. Because in India, it is not a payment tool. It is just an investment tool. Like in MCX. In MCX, you can buy gold. It is legal. But you cannot use gold as a payment tool. It's as same as gold. Gold can be used as an investment. But you can't pay anybody for a thing in a gold. That is not allowed. In the same format, cryptocurrency is not allowed in India to pay out the thing. I hope I was able to make
this. Yeah, I think that's really helpful. Another question which I want to understand, you know, as far as your company is concerned, are there any current users on the platform? And if yes, what is the current transaction size in India and maybe globally, wherever the platform exists, your specific platform?
We have a huge number of clients. And along with the clients, we have our physical office also across India. If suppose you go on a Google map and you press out PCX trading, you'll find at least 50 to 60 physical offices across India, whether it's Mumbai, whether it's Delhi, whether it's Calcutta, whether it's Bangalore, you'll find physical offices. Along with that, we have various associates which don't have the offices. Along that, customers are available and volumes are good enough. If you're going to check on the site, I don't remember per day volume because it's huge. So I can't differentiate it, but it's a good volume.
Sure. And you know, what kind of license is required by a master and unit and even for a freelancer? Because we talked about freelancers who can also come and trade. We talked about master franchisee and the sub-broker. So what kind of licenses are required by people who are working on these platform as partners?
So I'd like to give an example of someone at this point. You know, being a broker, it takes a huge amount, a huge investment. Like we talk about Motilal, Oswal, yeah. We talk about India Bulls, a software which is used cost me about 2 to 5 crore rupees. We came up with 14 lakh rupees. That is the amount required for integration and creating your all background things. You're creating a website and all. Why we came up with this policy? This was inspired by Reliance. Like Reliance came up with 500 phone, 500 rupees, you can have a phone. In the same format, we came up that you don't need to spend 2 crore, 5 crore rupees to get the software done. You can have just 14 lakh rupees and you can integrate entire software with you. Because our business is not to sell softwares. Our business is to generate volumes and generate brokerages. For franchisee, There's no fees, only registration charges are there. That is near about 12,000, in which we do KYC for the person. We issue his agreements, certificates, and these things are done. That takes a cost. So we don't charge anything from anyone.
But there's a bridge. I think what I saw in the presentation in the financials was also a license fee of 25,000. What is that towards? What kind of license fee is?
There was no license fee of 25,000. It was only 12,000. Just 12,000.
I think we did see a license fee mentioned, which was 25,000. And also coming on that 12,000 figure, there's an amount of 12,626, which was on the presentation, which also occurs again in the fourth year. So every 4 years, it needs to be invested?
No, it is not an investment. It's just a registration and your KYC part to be done. We provide you a certificate. And after 3 years, it has to be renewed so that we come to know the point. Suppose Ms. Chavi has taken out a brokership. After 3 years, she has to complete all KYCs and she has to go through the same process. It is renewable, but for this purpose that she is there. She is the actual person. For that purpose.
Okay. And you know, what kind of places, I think I'll take some of the questions from the audience. So we have Mr. Kapil Munjal. He said, can I start this from my own home and do I need a commercial space to begin with this business?
Exactly. You require a commercial space, whether you start it from home, but you require a dedicated place where a client can come and sit. Because we want to give a touch to the client. We want to give a touch to the investor where he can come up with his problems. So you require a proper space for that. Whether it can be a smaller space, it's fine.
Okay. And you know, while I think you did mention that territory is not a limitation here and people can trade across borders, but we still like to understand, because we talk about a master franchise model and a unit which comes under him. Is there still a territory which you would offer and you would not appoint any other unit or a master? And how is that territory defined?
We can't define territory because it's a global platform. So territory can't be defined. This is defined in our sense that after some time, brokership, a bigger thing, won't be distributed. Because it is not a thing that can be distributed in every street. Only franchiseeship would be available. We have some figure in our mind that as soon as we reach this level, we will stop selling brokership in this country and we'll move to other country. So that our brokers can grow up. We don't want to create much competition between them.
Okay, now with the master franchise model, are we looking at all cities with the same lens, which means the investment for a master franchisee would remain same for a city like Bangalore, Kolkata, Delhi, or maybe a smaller state, or it would be based on the potential or the opportunity that you see, because the financial that we saw were very standard for a master franchisee. So what? How do we define a master franchisee? Is that the state master, is a city master? What geographies are we taking into consideration when we define this master franchisee?
Master franchisee or broker is a person who can acquire more franchises under his hierarchy. And the criteria for that person is that he should have a prior experience of handling those people. He should have a proper knowledge regarding NSC, BSC and commodities. And a franchisee can only acquire clients.
Correct. Absolutely. It's a terminal you get. It's a broking terminal you get. And under the terminal, you can have a lot of other franchisees coming in, which can further acquire clients. And a broker can trade himself also. He has both B2C model and B2C also direct model. So this is a great opportunity. Few brokers would be allowed to come in, and every exchange would have the few broking. The broking is a limited structure, and then you can mass distribute. And as I said, if a good broker has a competence, then he can create a network all over India, not only India, but you can take it anywhere in the world. So great. I think we've come down to our 1 o'clock is already there. So any last comments you have, Sandeep, Chavi, anything you want to share with our audience, which you want to really talk about? You are in a futuristic at the right timing. And we see that you're very committed to the business. And you've done, the hard work you've done, and next 2 to 3 years, it will all start paying off. And we want to really see that your offices and exchanges all over India, not only India, but globally. And we will be happy to participate in your growth, not only for Indian subcontinent, but other markets also. So over to you for your last comments.
Sure, Chavi, I was going to thank you a lot. And she was waiting out
So I think that this tenure of maybe 2-2.5 years that we've given to this business, so we've done a lot in this tenure. We've made a well to go to the market product, a product which has not been explored by anyone so far. So none of the crypto businesses have jumped into a B2B model. None of the stock market businesses have stepped into the crypto market. So we made a good product. We've made a good network of franchisees, freelancers, and brokers. We have a good clientele and volume in the market. The reason that this product was launched in the market was to give a new opportunity to retailers, to entrepreneurs, to small businesses to explore a new business opportunity, to explore a new broking business. So I think this is a really, booming and a lucrative business opportunity for people who want to start their broking business, people who also want to associate as freelancers, or if they have a bigger scale, they can associate as a broker. So like we've discussed that the broker platform is just as, India Bulls and Share Khan. So it is just their own platform customized for their requirements with their logo. So I'm sure that people are going to, show a lot more interest in this business opportunity. And we look forward to continue exploring this product and expanding this product to next levels and next heights.
And Gauravji, great thanks to you. And we hope after Franchisee India's success, people are going to run behind Franchisee India for this, that you made us successful.
Absolutely. Absolutely. It's a very... And we believe in what you're doing, and you rightly at the right time and right space. And the years, coming years, I think we'll see a lot of education, a lot of development in this, and you will be front runner for that. Absolutely. Excited to be partner with you.
One thing that we also have campaigns for education of our brokers and franchisees.
Correct. That's where it should be led by education, more confidence of investors, more performance and investor confidence would rise. It will become, look at mutual fund, in last two decades, where mutual fund volume has gone. It's just purely from education and distribution.
We have our blockchain trainers, we have our sales trainers, we have other portions, and we come up always with a new activity so that we can educate more, because education is required in India. Correct. Most of the people don't understand blockchain. They don't understand this business till today.
Absolutely. And that's where... No, everything, even look at, I give the example of the stock market or mutual fund. I mean, mutual fund is, look at the volume we are doing in India, but it's still very small. Their association is doing a campaign called Mutual Fund Sahi Hai. Idea is that still people don't know how to really invest. And this is also, it's a big journey, and India is one of the largest investment spaces, and it will continue to rise. And, so, Sonia, your last comments before we call Archana for final. Thank you.
I'd like to thank both of you, Sandeepji and Chavi, for giving this presentation. And I maybe echo and second the thought of education. Even the IMF also released some videos, I think some months back, educating people on cryptocurrencies and taking an informed decision when they invest in a business like this. I'd like to thank you again. While we have some questions which I see coming in from Mr. Prakash and Vikas, I'll request all of viewers who are there, any information that you want to seek or you want to delve into more details, kindly reach out on a hotline number, and we'll help you reach out to the company and set up maybe one day in the coming week where all your questions you can ask, understand maybe a little bit about your backgrounds, cities that you come from, and the model that you're interested in. I think freelancer, I have last question which I see on free Lancer model. So please let us know which model, which city, little bit about you. And a hotline number is there already in the chat, which you can take a note of, and we'll fix up a call and get you on a one-on-one discussion with the team. So over to you, Archana, for your final remarks.
And we will also keep one day. I think let's keep the date of any day preference for you, Sandeep ji, jis din hum kuch meetings kara sakte hain aapki?
Sure, so we can discuss it after meeting.
Okay, perfect. Thank you. Okay, Archana, over to you.
So thank you so much, Ms. Ahuja, Mr. Fugat, and Ms. Shukla for joining us today and presenting your business idea with us. We would like to thank our panel member, as always, for your word of caution and advice to each one of us. Thank you. Last but not the least, all the panelists who are joining us today and witnessing the great success of brands we present every day. We would like to invite all the feedback, suggestions, your recommendation at our business hotline number, which is 9717683838. That's the number which we request to save in your phone book so that you get a regular update from our side on industry, on various brands. Once you save it, you'll receive all the messages through broadcast. You can connect with the management team of Franchise India at their respective LinkedIn IDs. We, the team of Franchise India, is always there to help each one of you. The recorded version of this particular webinar
I think we lost Archana. So this is a recorded version of Facebook. It's all available on the Facebook page. And tomorrow we are presenting another opportunity called Mad About Dogs. It's a pet store already running successfully. Hyderabad, Surat and Calcutta.
Now, sharp at 12 p.m. to witness the journey of Mad. Mad About Dogs. That's the brand we are presenting to you tomorrow. So do not miss this chance. Please join us tomorrow for this particular great webinar. Thank you so much once again for joining us today. Have a great day ahead. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Great day ahead.